Now we are going to do a line-wise explanation of the poem. I'll be reading two lines and then I will be explaining their meaning. Where the mind is without fear and the head is held high, where knowledge is free, where the world has not been broken up into fragments by narrow domestic walls. Here the poet says that he aspires, he dreams of a country where all the countrymen have their held high in dignity, where all have their self-esteem, where nobody is fearful of holding their heads high and nobody is subjugated or oppressed, where knowledge is free, where knowledge is not limited to the upper caste as it was in the British rule, where it is not limited to only the Brahmins, where everybody is given knowledge irrespective of their caste, creed or class, where world has not been broken up into fragments by narrow domestic walls, where my country, he says, the poet says, where his country has not been divided by the issues of caste, class, creed, prejudices and superstitions, where his countrymen stand united, where words come out from the depth of truth, where the countrymen speak the truth, speak from their heart, are truthful and not superficial, where tireless striving stretches its arms towards perfection, where the countrymen work tirelessly day and night towards perfection, someday reaching the goal, and where they're not ignorant, where they're not ignorant, where they're not callous of what the work they're doing, where they're not lazy away, where the clear stream of reason has not lost its way. So here, the clear stream is of logical thinking. So clear stream is a metaphor that has been used for logical thinking. Into the dreary desert of dead sand, of dead habit. Dead habit, again, is a metaphor used for old superstitions and beliefs. So where the clear stream of reason has not lost its way, into the dreary desert sand of dead habit, where logical thinking rules, where rational thinking is present and superstitions and harmful beliefs do not stand in the way of progress. Where the mind is led forward by thee, where the countrymen have a broad-minded and progressive thinking, into ever-widening thought and action, into that heaven of freedom, my father, let my country awake. Where everybody provokes thought, provokes action, and inspires them as well into such a heaven. The poet compares such a country which has the freedom of work, of education. He compares such a country to heaven and he wants India to awake into such a country and he wants the God Almighty to lead us to that.